Yesterday, it was announced that Donald Trump is suing Hillary Clinton and, of course, the DNC for trying to link his campaign to the Russians in 2016. So, yeah, 5.5 years after all of that blew up, Donald Trump finally decided, you know what? I'm a little pissed. I'm a little agitated this week. Still clearly bitter. So let's sue these people for their, quote, opposition research. That's actually what they mentioned. Their oppo research, you know, was trying to link us to Russia, and then it sparked this Mueller investigation and, you know, put us through hell. And then, of course, you know, the company that was, like, maybe spying on me at Trump Tower, which, of course, all of that, you know, was pretty much accounted for and explained. They weren't actually spying on you. They were just checking where traffic was coming from. And no, that wasn't the DNC or Hillary Clinton that was actually doing that. But either way, Trump says, screw it, I'm suing you. I'm suing you because of the talking points, basically. Now, here's where I'm going to surprise everybody. I hope he wins. I know, shocker, right? And no, for the record, it's not because I hate the Russiagate story. I believe there was a there. It's not because I hate Hillary Clinton or the DNC. But I want Trump to win. Because do you have any idea what a victory for Donald Trump would do to political campaigns moving forward in this country? It would open the door, finally, to be able to sue these politicians for slandering and defaming one another in their political ads, because that is essentially what he's trying to sue for. How many times have you seen a political ad on TV? And talking to my audience here, I'm assuming most of you are on the left and you've seen these commercials from the right and you want to scream at your TV because everything they're saying is a lie. Well, unfortunately, under the way the laws work now, their opponents who they're lying about cannot sue for defamation. But if this Trump lawsuit is successful, which it has zero chance of being for the record, it's not going to win at all. But if it were to be successful, it would set the precedent that you could sue your opponent for this slander and libel coming from their opposition research. That would be huge. That would probably help to clean up all of these horrible political ads and get them off the air. And if we get the propaganda and the lies off the air, then by God, maybe we're going to start seeing some of these Republicans lose. That's why I want Trump to be successful, because it's going to backfire on the Republicans. And sure, oh, it'll cost them, you know, tens of millions of dollars. Pfft, whatever, they got it. Pay it. Make it happen. Go along with it. Because if this is successful, it would rewrite the laws for political advertising in this country in a way that would benefit the Democrats. Having said all of that, like I mentioned, this case has absolutely no chance of succeeding. It doesn't even make any sense. That's the biggest part. Like, I'm suing you because of these things that happened and the Mueller investigation, which, of course, did lead to indictments and arrests and jail time. So it wasn't exactly a witch hunt, but sure, I'm suing you for it. It's going to get laughed out of court, but I wish it wouldn't, because sure, it may sting the Democrats in the right now, but in the long run, this would be the worst thing to ever happen to the Republican Party. Thanks for watching. And if you like what you saw, don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our Ring of Fire channel here.